Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Greenskins campaign. We're going to continue with it, essentially. So, if you're watching on YouTube, please do leave a like for this campaign. It is very much appreciated. If we could get this part 2 to like several hundred likes, that would be absolutely fantabulously amazing, and it really does help my channel out a lot. Probably more than you realise. So, but without further ado, we're going to keep on streaming as the Greenskins, or playing as the Greenskins. And we're on our way to Valhalla's Sorrow, because I think that I was on my way to kind of pretty much wipe out the Red Fangs before I went to go and do this, the Battle of the Thundering Falls. So I wanted to secure my flank first, and then go and destroy them, essentially. So, I'm just going to make sure that I haven't got anything that I need to do. So we've got that, better stinkers. Okay. Building required a goblin tinkerer bench. So we need to get some... We need to build a goblin tinkerer bench somewhere. So let's see. But I need a level 2 settlement for that. So I need to wait till we grow a little bit. Oh, that's actually... That's growing. Okay. And then I'll get a goblin tinkerer camp there. So we can actually start researching. I should have done that beforehand. Valhalla's Sorrow? I think we're just going to auto-resolve this. I don't really think I need to fight it. My force is pretty powerful. I think they've already got that attached. Yeah. Okay. We'll just auto-resolve this. I don't need to fight this. We shouldn't really take too many casualties either. Just a few goblins. Just a few goblins being destroyed. So there we go. And we're going to occupy that. Weapon gained, the Shrieking Blade causes terror. This blade was stolen from a tomb banshee while she sang a haughty nursery tale to a forgotten child. Now the blade sings too and shrieks when she strikes a foe. Okay, and I think Grimgor has upgraded again, so we're going to... We're going to go for the Du Bois, so increase our melee attack. Nothing's damaged there. And then I think we can go after the Crooked Fang 4. And I think that'll be their final settlement. There he is. He's the Harbinger of Gork. Yeah, let's just double check. So the Crooked Moon like me. The Red Fangs. Wow, they've got quite a lot of territory. I didn't actually realise that they had that much. I reckon that's probably their last two settlements, though. Huh. If I max out the yellow bar, I will get a war. Indeed, the war. What graphic settings am I using?
The bloodlust of your boys has attracted more of your kin to their banner.
There we go.
Your forces are unstoppable.
So we got the high fightiness rating in order to do that. So let's set the war target for the Crooked Fang 4. I'm playing... Everything is on Ultra. Just so you're aware. So that's plus 11 at the minute. How are we doing in the crag? One more turn before we can start building what I'd like. Two turns. Oh, because we haven't got a... Right. Well, I think an army of 19 is enough. Okay. Sweet. Hello to any new viewers tuning in. Good to see you. But really, that's not a bad little army we've got now. I mean, that's a lot of goblins. But, yep. Blaze Evertide, thank you for the follow.
Not humies. Yeah. You'll be lucky to still be breathing in a moment.
What GPU have I got? I've got a 980 Ti. I will take that. I will accept military access with you for now.
Consider raising a camp in the lands of the enemy, Savage Lord. It shall become a base from which your warriors can raid these pathetic lands.
Your warriors range deep into hostile lands, but all is not well. There are dark omens abroad, and if the shadow of some horned god was watching from the evil moon above, the army is fettered by Morthleb's glare. I think I'll go... I will improve the omens. I know it's expensive to do, but I think it'll be worthwhile. And can you actually... No, we can only march. Okay. But I think now that I can actually build... Oh, bugger. Okay, no, I can't. I need to wait till that's level 3, and then I can start researching. Right, fine. I'll just get something that will give me... I should have noticed that before. We're going to increase... We already have one boss tent. I'm going to increase that. And then we can get a goblin watchtower, which will improve... Pile of shiny stuff. That is very appealing. I do like shiny stuff myself. Could get goblin wolf riders. But I'm probably going to be going for more heavy infantry, I think. So we'll go for a pile of shiny stuff. I do like the shinies. Right. Yeah, war.
Dare approach me.
Oh, God, they're going to declare war, aren't they?
If I don't like what you say, Mork will be eating your guts tonight.
I'm not going to have peace with the dwarves. What? That is... No. 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 Oh, I should have had peace with the dwarves. I should have had peace with the dwarves. They're coming down with a full step.
Because my chopper Gitznik wants to mash her.
I will take that. Right, so I need to move back. Oh my. The lads were wondering which of the gods to shout first in the war cry. Some of the boys want to shout Mork because he's brutally cunning, while the others want to start with Gork because he's cunningly brutal. So, Mork gives me plus 3 fighting this. Gork gives me plus... I'll go for Gork. That's a pretty easy... What? Oh, the war... Oh, you took it. Oh, thanks. Okay. Well... I'll set the war target for Karak Azgal now. While I'm going to set... If that fails, then that's fine. We've got a dwarven force here, Karaka's Ghoul. But I really need to, with Grimgore, I need to get the heck out of Dodge. So we're going to go in the... Actually, that doesn't really matter. We're going to march back up to our home provinces. So Forgrim is going to take Iron Rock. That's pretty much guaranteed. But now we've taken the Crooked Fanged Fort. I'm going to raise... We're going to recruit a hero, I think. Oh, no, we recruit a lord. So we're going to have an orc war boss. Mork is best. Do I think pixelated Apollo looks like Jesus? I think it looks like pixelated Apollo. Right, so he's deformed by birth or by ruinous powers. There is an omen over the prison of flesh. He's blind. Okay. Jeez. I would like a shaman, though. So you got a maimed leg. I'm just going to go for the maimed leg guy. Why not? Zagrak Troll Eater. If you have any suggestions to what to name him, I've got a wizard in my Empire campaign called Harry Potter, but if anyone wants to rename this fella, Zagrak Troll Eater, I'll try not to die, Havoc. Let me know. you have any fun ideas. I'll take a look at the chat in a sec while I just deal with this kind of stuff. So, I need to... It's the scabby eye.
Get in. What can we do for our fellow greenies?
Oh. They'll join my confederation already. Wow. Boaty McBoatface, Leggy McMame, Sakura Wins, Dogbert Eater. So well, I'm going to take control over these, over that tribe then, I guess. But
I'm special.
So we got Leggy McMame. We'll go for Leggy McMame. I was tempted to go for yours, Haxo. Sakura Wins. But I'm going to go for Leggy McMame. There we are. So, let's take a little look at the diplomacy. Because Scabby Eye, they seem to want to join my territory. Which I wasn't expecting. I don't think the Crooked Moon would want to, would they?
What do you want?
They will as well. So the, we could get the Crooked Moon. However, Scabby Eye are over here. Who are they at war with? And they're only at war with Karak Azul. So that these territories will be relatively safe. I say relatively safe. They're near the dwarves. So, hello, Lionheart XOXO10. Red Fangs don't like me, so they're going to get wiped out. The Teeth Snatchers.
Right. I'm the boss, because I got my...
Okay. I'm not going to join any confederation just yet. I want to get my stuff sorted first. And... I think the Crooked Moon, I might lose Karak 8 Peaks. Actually, no. That's got a strong garrison, actually. So, yeah, that's good. That's good. I am the war boss. Okay, so I'm going to go for the Crooked Moon. They're going to join me.
What can we do for our fellow?
And they're going to pay me for the freaking privilege. Alright, they're going to give me lots of money. Oh, okay, maybe not. They're going to give me some money. Okay. They're going to join my confederation and you're going to give me a little bit of money for the privilege. There we go. So, the Crooked Moon have been absorbed into my territories. So, I think that they only had that one force. So, Taka with the war, we're still going. Our fightiness rating is good. So, you're going to withdraw. I have no idea what you're doing. Where are you? What are you doing? Let me move you. Oh, you're raiding. Oh, God. You're raiding your own territory, you freaking plonkers. We's be stomping them ummies soon, boss. We're going to be stomping some. Joey couldn't get that diplomacy on Norma. Well, you know, I guess I'm a better Grimgore. And I just need to rename the Black Crag while we're here. If it fits. Rambler Town! My capital will always be Rambler Town on any campaign I do. So, just to make you all aware. So we should set a new target. I think this the war target is set for Karak Azgal. Yeah, so that's set for there. Okay. You have a low fightiness. I know you do, but I can't do... Oh. We're going to quell... animosity. So, really, you guys are pretty rubbish then, aren't you? I'm going to be streaming for quite some time. So, make sure to tune in. Spread this stream and this video around. A great migration of the tribes comes to our borders, demanding shelter and wanting to join the fighting. Not normally a problem, but this don't smell right. I'm gonna go for get out of here. Ain't no zogging room for these gits. Shove off. That is hilarious. Actually, I think you're right. I'm probably going to disband them because this guy is. They're pretty. Although that Goblin Wolf Chariot's pretty sweet. Okay. Well, we'll withdraw to Karak, 8 peaks. But why is that? Events, extorted income. Well, let's get rid of a few units. Just so we're making some money. And how is that army doing? They're on the march. I don't actually. Because could Karak 8 peaks hold by itself? And we've got lots of orc biggins, orc boys. We'd have a good go at defending that. I think with Grimor, we're going to go up there. We've only been streaming for a little while, so not too long. Definitely going to get a heap of shiny stuff. Heck yes. Gotta love all the shiny stuff. All the shiny stuff. Okay. So I think I'd rather have my army led by Leggy McMain rather than this guy in Karak 8 Peaks. So I'm going to transfer. Going to go up to Valiath Sorrow. Transfer these troops and get rid of Sour because he's just a. I have no interest in you. No interest whatsoever. Can't really build anything here, but my territory has expanded quite a lot considering we're only like 12 turns into the campaign. So I think we're doing alright. Yeah, 12 turns. Hello, everyone. Right. So it appears they've withdrawn. Who, the bloody spears? Are we friendly with you? You don't hate me.
What a warning.
But you don't want anything else. Scabby eye, you're still okay with me. What's teeth snatchers?
This is my tribe.
No. Grimor will destroy you all. So if anyone's got any names for units, such as the Black Orcs or the Doom Diver, let me know and I will kind of change those over as well. Because I want to kind of try and make this as interactive for you as possible. So I think I might have enough forces to take on the Thundering Fools. Dwarf Warriors, Miners, Quarrelers and a Grudge Thrower. So that range is 420. We've got a range of 400. I'm doing good, Alex. Thank you very much for asking. Da Immortals. Okay. I'm going to have to put capitals in, otherwise that'll bug me. Okay. The New Zealand rugby team. That I'm going to call them the Immortals for now. But that is a very good one. That's really funny. So we're going to continue. We'll continue on. We'll get out of our current stance. I need to improve my public order, though. Which at the minute is proving to be a bit of a problemo. Okay, so the dwarves appear to be closing in. We've encountered the top knots.
Here we go.
We are besieging Karak Azghul. Wow, okay. That took me a long time to walk that. Right. So I have 19 units. I think I can take on this battle. We'll give it a go. So in terms of campaign difficulty, I think we're... Oh, bugger. Okay, well, I forgot to change my stance, so that's my own fault. So I'll do that soon. Top knots.
All right, you got my attention.
I'm not going to call it the baby lobber. That's nah. Not going to do that. Okay, so I'll get out of my stance next turn. That's just my own fault for being unobservant. And I think I'm going to sneeze soon. Oh yeah, it's because I was in a raiding stance, so it messed up. Okay, so. Go out of our stance. Right, so the Battle of the Thundering Falls. So they're going to have reinforcements with gyro bombers and gyrocopters. But I reckon we could do this. There we go. Kaboom! Well, my coaster would just fall on. I'm using a Game of Thrones coaster.
The stunties come to stop us.
The stunties come.
Time for a rock, I say. I'm going to enjoy pulling these beers from their chins. First, though, we need to break their big guns. That's just cheating. I want some boys on that straight away. Stop their artillery from shooting, and we get more time scrapping. Just as Morg likes it. Watch it, though. Just because they're short, don't mean one or two of them ain't handy with their own troubles. They like fighting underground, but so do we. Ask any rat man under Mount Red Eye. Right, boys, that's the plan. Immortals, get your choppers out. This one's gonna be fun.
The 10th Terry Legion. So yeah, I'm gonna use the Grudge Throwers to... Sorry, I'm gonna use my Doom Divers to take out the Grudge Throw... Yeah, that's the Grudge Thrower. Oh, we would have been in range... Far in range anyway, okay. So we are gonna rush them. In fact, we're almost in range of the Arrow Boys as well. Wow, yeah, this is like going to be pretty much just a charge head on in. Grimgore's going to get in there as well. I'll use the Black Orcs as a reserve. I'll use my Boar Boys on this flank with the Goblins, actually. So we'll get those there.
Oh, yeah.
Alex, thank you.
Been looking forward to a green skin campaign. A-A-A-N-D, your voice is soothing. Here, have a tip. To eat them.
Thank you very much, Alex. That was very generous of you. Thank you very much for the donation. It's always very much appreciated. Never expected. So that is... I'm very grateful. That is very nice of you. Thank you very much. And your reward will be... me destroying these dwarves. I hope. But thank you once again. That's very nice of you. I'm glad you find my voice soothing. So here we go. Dwarf Warriors. I do like the fact that they've changed the army paints in some of the units. So at least we get that kind of customization. Okay. Go in. Wow, yeah, I think they're going to have a tough time. I think I might have to commit my Black Orcs, though. Eat the angry midgets. Victory is within our grasp, it's true. Their whirly-weak reinforcements have arrived. Up there! Bummer. Okay, missiles. Oh, you gits. Target him. Get him. Right. I wish I could zoom in and, like, fight it like that, but it's a bit difficult. Are they actually headbutting my dwarf? You gits, you gyrocopter gits. Yes, I was provided with a review copy by Creative Assembly. I do usually get early access to stuff, so I was happy that they sent me this as well. I usually get access to Creative Assembly titles since the Imperator Augustus edition of Rome 2, actually. So Grimgor is having a good time against Valar Minewood. I mean, I can probably... Go, Grimgor, go! Look at that! You are no match for Grimgor! Oh, he's already routing. Good. Victory! Can you control the artillery? Yes, you can. Would I say it's worth £40? I think if you like Total War and you like Warhammer, then yes, I'd say it's worth buying. At the minute, my score would probably be about an 8.5 out of 10. The sieges can be a bit linear, but I'd say it's definitely worth it. It's definitely the most polished title Creative Assembly have ever released on release. By far, it's the most polished title. So, they better flyers. They better flyers anyway. Oh, we're gonna... Do we eat them or slaughter them? I think we're gonna slaughter them. Oh, you got a backstabber. So, we've also got Gambler's Armor. And Ugmug Crooked. There we go. Where are you? Ah. Right. You have leveled up once again. Ooh. Yeah, we'll go after Hatred this time. Do I think this is better? I prefer it to Attila. However, once the Medieval Kingdoms campaign comes out, then it's going to be interesting. Okay, so. We're still at war with the Red Fangs. The Dwarves. Probably going to have to put my glasses soon. How depressing is that? Scabby Eye. Where are you? Bloody Spears. Oh, so you're not that favourable to me anymore. Hmm. Oh, I get a confederation penalty. So rather than conquering, I did it as a confederation. So they don't like that, so they don't. We're going to lose Crooked Fang 4 before I can do anything about it. This magic is real. All right, I'll move. Nope. And then you can go away. So, I'm probably going to withdraw to Karak. I know withdrawing is very... kind of boring, but we need to kind of consolidate. A Danish king. I'm not sure. I need to... It's been a long time since I actually checked on the donations thing. No comments. Hmm?
Let's go.
Right, let's check on our character details. Melee defense plus 5. We'll switch. Okay. Right. I think I'll end the turn again. As predicted, we're going to lose that. There is no point in me really fighting that. That is a beastly army. So, Cazador Dragonslayer, the Gits. I don't know about that, user.
Your prestige grows, my lord.
Oh, there we go.
News of your conquest spreads far and wide.
Objective complete.
Your developing power is noted by even the most distant of kings and bestial lords.
Ah. Okay, get the Gits in order. If the Greenskins are going to fear Grimgor, as they should, then he must take control and build up a great green empire from which he can launch an invasion to crush all enemies. The local tribes must fall in line or get a proper boot in. So yeah, we're going to loot, we're going to get a rebellion in the Eastern Badlands. My war army is still okay. I think where I can, I'm going to get peace with the dwarves up here. There's no point in me fighting them too much. I want to get everything else secure first. So focus on getting everything secure and then marching north. They're going to pay me for peace though. I know it's not good to take peace with the dwarves, but it's in my interest for now. So that gives me... Now I'm able to actually focus on Karak Azul. So we'll move there.
Mork says what?
He can join us. Minus 10. Oh my god. Stop rebelling, please. Unfortunately, I can't hook anyone up with a copy of the game. Okay. So, how do I get there? We'll move over here, then move through like the underground pathways so we can go and take the Black Iron Mine. Then when that rebels, we'll get that sorted. Here, we'll move... Can we recruit here? Oh, it's only global. But if we go back into our home province, then we can start recruiting. So we're getting some pretty poo units, but that's fine for now. What's happening? Oh, we've taken Karak Azgal. Okay, so we're going to get a rebellion in pretty much every territory. So I'm prepared for that. No, we don't need to use the underway just yet. We're going to march.
Come on.
Black Crag. We can actually upgrade to a level 3 settlement now.
The tribe's ready.
I'm just going to build up some troops just so we can quell rebellions when they appear. down in Karak Zgal. Can give you a... You need to go and attack them. Not sure there's any point building anything at the minute. So, just a quick one. Thank you all for following so far. I know I haven't been mentioning every name, but there's been too many coming in. So, but thank you. I do really appreciate everyone who has followed. It's great to see you show interest in my channel. So thank you very much. We are going to stomp the stunties. Those stunties ain't going to know what's hit them. Wow, okay, so the dwarves are fighting back. They've defeated my army. Uh-oh. It's going to involve fighting, don't you? Actually, yeah, he hasn't been fighting enough, so we actually need to... Yeah, we can get there. And then next turn, we are going to take that settlement. Leggy. 14v8, that shouldn't be a problem. Gonna auto-resolve this one. We're gonna keep on chasing him down. But he can go up to level 2 now. Huzzah! Okay. So we've lost control of pretty much that entire province. We're getting pushed back quite a lot. But I think we're going to soon get the strike back. I am playing on hard difficulty, yes. Oh, you git. So they are weakened a fair amount. I'm going to have to Oh, they got trolls. And a doom diver. Well, I'll see if I can I'll see if I can destroy them. This is going to be interesting. This is certainly going to be a bit more interesting. If this goes badly, then that rebellion's going to grow into something that I can't easily get rid of. We're going to start the deployment. I should have manually fought that other battle. That was a tactical mistake. Wolf chariot. Great Simon. Right. So they have... a doom diver. Whew. Yeah, that rebellion. Yeah. And then, especially with the frickin' Doom Diver, I'm gonna have a hard time here. Oh, jeez. I'm going to be playing this campaign. I'm not going to be playing Chaos. And we're having to fight uphill as well. Gosh damn it, Gork and Mork, give me some kind of advantage here. So, we're firing. Sending my goblin chariots. Try and take down the goblin wolf riders. Oh no. Actually, let's take down the doom divers. I think that spell's glitchy. Oh my god. My warriors are already fleeing. So, my infantry doesn't really appear to be up to much compared to theirs, although the trolls are routing. They are monstrous, so if we can get rid of them now. Ignore those. We've routed the Doom Diver. Let's try and run down Sly with our goblin chariots. Gonna keep on buffing. Try and kind of do a bit of a chain thing here. If we can take out Sly, I think we might have a chance. Come on. Please. Please. But this might be the end of Leggy McMame already. That'd be embarrassing, but I think it's a possibility. However this goes, though, we have done well to kill what we have. Please kill him. Oh my god, he's got 180 health. What's he down to? The enemy lord's dead. Okay, that should incite a mass rout, hopefully. They've still got a lot of troops left, but slowly they are perishing. Time will tell, though. It's starting to go in my favour. Blob and attack. 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 So they're down to 200 men. Oh, crap. Take this room! Take this room! Okay, you're still alive. This is still like... This is still not going how I wanted it to. Crumbs. Stop fleeing. For the love of God, stop fleeing. No! Wow. Help him. Help out Leggy. No! No, stop running, stop running, stop running, stop running. It's the cavalry. They've just managed to, like, envelop me completely. leave them alone. Okay, let's try. The thing is, they're just swarming me around here, so Orc boys should keep them at bay. Okay, it's a chain route, and I can't chase them down. Might be able to shoot a few of them, though. Even though, even you're out of range. Pyrrhic victory, but we won. Woohoo! Lost 760 of our troops, though. That sucks, but... We're going to replenish. So that's Sly killed. So, do I have enough? No, I don't. Oh my god. Well, replenish. And we'll recruit more troops. You're going to go and take this mine, Grimgor. Auto-resolve that one. We lost 700. Okay, in the iron mine. I think we're going to get... Could get the muster fields. Gonna get the shiny stuff. Okay. Let's take a little look at the situation. And I'm gonna have to put my glasses on. Co-op is just two people. Eyes are getting a bit strained, so... Need to do that. Okay, so you're staying the same, that's fine. They are quite powerful. I need to get this rebellion under control. Then I should be okay. Looks like the scabby eye getting destroyed. I think the dwarves have utterly annihilated them. Get the lads. Raise an army. But I've already done... Oh my god. No, why?
The tribe's ready.
They've got black orcs now.
Right, don't move.
I don't believe that. So, I'm going to have to send freaking Grimgor back. Oh my god. Right, you can just keep recruiting.
Oh, get here. That works.
But that rebellion has utterly, utterly screwed me. That's a bummer. Oh, no, no. You're going to go on the mount, Goblin Big Boss. But these guys are going to be a right pain to defeat now. We're replenishing. But they got Black Orcs, Trolls, Doom Divers. Jeez. Ah! Really? It gives me that much of a chance? What? I'm still gonna give it a go. Of course. I was gonna use the underway, but it didn't let me get there fast enough. So I was gonna use it this turn. When I clicked on it before, it didn't really give me the option to... I think that's enough. Do we have any high ground? No. We're down the frickin' hill again. Okay. Okay.
The war is here. Wait for war. The war is here.
Wolf chariot.
Well. Looks like Leggy McMame is going to die. Wow, okay. So, at least they're charging, so they might take a... Look at that slope. Yeah, I don't really want to attack up that. So I'd rather them... come to me. It's still quite a big slope. And I've only got Orc boys. Just, how did they get Black Orcs in their frickin' rebellion, the stupid gits? And in come the Doom Divers. Oh my god, they are devastating. Just try and move out of there. Impact.
The enemy use the forests to conceal their movements, my lord. Approach with caution.
So I'll route what I can. Buff everyone. I'm just going to focus on taking out what I can. So when Grimgore comes in, he can actually hopefully finish off this rebellion and I can rebuild. I might just have to take a couple of turns to consolidate though, unfortunately. But here we go, the men are starting to flee already. Ugh. Please fight. They lost against goblins. Are you having a laugh? Wow.
This is gonna be fun!
A rebellion is what happened. And I'm fighting on a rubbish map with poor lighting. Oh. They lost 71. I don't... What? That's... Ugh. Oh, that's annoying. That's frustrating. So there goes Leggy. Leggy be dead. If I get another rebellion, I am utterly, utterly screwed. So I could get trolls, or I could get a tinkerer bench. Tinkerer bench will actually allow me to research stuff in the goblin workshop, which is probably more important at the minute. Warrior loves me with glasses on. Well, thanks very much, sir. Thanks very much. Right, so we're going to have to do something because this is not going well. Sour? I don't know. I don't really like sour. I will, however, raise a recruit another lord. Actually have a war boss this time. Oh, okay. Minus 15 to recruitment cost. Good. So I will engage them next turn. Hopefully. And hopefully we'll win. I do have a mage. I've got some black orcs. Wasn't how I wanted this to go. Oh my god. So we need to defend a crack. I think we might do that. We're going to lose, but we'll kill whatever dwarves we can. It was all going fine for like 10 turns. And then it's... Yeah. Now it's not going so good. So, I'm going to make sure that as many towers are in operation as possible. So, wherever they're going to attack from. Okay.
The enemy advanced towards the city, Commander. Do all you can to stop them breaching the walls.
Is that going to do anything? Is that causing any damage? 8%, so it's not causing that much damage. So we're not going to stop the siege towers, but I can probably take out more of their men. Although... I think we were actually... Might be able to take out one before he gets to me. Can't do much about the goblins there. Is that siege equipment destroyed? Good. Good. Keep destroying it. You need to get over here. But really, this is only going to go one way for me, and that's badly. Oh my gosh. Have I crashed? No, I haven't. Wow, for a second there, I was getting a bit worried. Fire on the quarrelers, boys. And this is where it ends. Oh boy. How many did we take out? I think we killed a few at least. So that's good. But yeah, goblins and orc boys against dwarf warriors. Oh jeez. Killing a few of them though. Killing a few. Please die. Please at least kill one. Are we killing them? Please kill them. Oi. So they're in the city. Oh my god. Wow. What's going on? This is what happens when you play a campaign. Things happen. Well, they've actually made a breach. Wow, they've taken down the walls. I'm just gonna speed this up. So they lost 271 taking that Karak, so that's good. At least we killed a couple of hundred. 300. Several hundred. Oi. Oh, at least the Red Fangs are attacking. That was rather stupid of that rebellion. Hello.
I'm the one true git. Ah.
That was very stupid of them. Oh my god. That was amazing. Hey! And we're getting a 1080. I've only just got a 980, so I'm not in any... I don't need to change. And we're going to eat these gits. Stupid rebellion. Okay, so that's solved. I'm slightly concerned. Actually, these two can just fight it out. The Red Fangs and those fellas, while I kind of keep on attacking. There we go. They'll buy the 980 from me. I got it like 2 months ago, so there's no way I'm going to sell it for half the price. We're definitely going to get a fight in pit. And we're going to march on Karak Azul. Oh no, we're taking attrition. That's bad. That's very bad. I made a mistake. I'm making lots of mistakes. Bloody spears, that's fine. Scabby eye, that's all good. Paint Grimoire red, then it'll go faster.
ask you one thing, understood? I'm the boss here.
So we could absorb them into our confederation. Get some more territory. And they appear to be willing to pay for the privilege. There we go. So with that, we've taken more territory. And we secured the Death Pass. Which I think here is where we can get extra obedience. Which again is what we need, so you need to go in that territory. Did I gain any armies? What? Oh my god. I'm just going to have to disband you all. What are you doing out there? Why did none of these... Why do none of you have any... Oh my god, this is... Ah! Am I around later? I might be Warrior Sparta. What kind of time? Okay. Oh dear. I might get rid of that in Mount Squighorn. So that's already increasing the... I haven't really built enough things. In the Death Pass, I don't need... that, and I'll change that for obedience. Okay, so I should be able to get it up. Yeah, I might be around then. I'll let you know on El Twitter. Okay. Ah, storm clouds gather in the north. There are rumours that the barbarous tribes residing in the shadow of Chaos's Seath, striving against each other for the attention of the dark gods, and are now banding together. Uh-oh. Oh, I have a war army. Okay, didn't even realise that. It's a shame they're going to take attrition straight away.
Don't think so.
Okay. Yeah, we're going to get a boss tent here. And we're going to upgrade that one, and then we can get a goblin big boss if we want. But yeah, I need to really do... I'm going to get another rebellion. Oh my god. Stop rebelling, you frickity... He gets. So we'll probably lose that. Crack 8 peaks. Do we at least have a decent garrison in there? So we should hold 8 peaks. Oh my gosh. Oh, thanks very much, you sliver solo. No. I'm going to fight them until we destroy them. Oh boy. So they're besieging
your
that.
Your new workshop opens the possibility of conducting research into better methods of war.
Research better Strikers.
Put your devious goblin minds to good use, my lord.
Yep, we're going to get another rebellion. This is not good. My god. This is frustrating.
Kill everything.
So I can't even take that with you. So I'm going to leave them to it. Gonna use the underway to go back here. Mount Squighorn, why are you? Okay, well that's a temporary measure. Till I can get everything else conquered. Wow, this is gonna take a while. Yep, I have played lots of Total War before. So they're willing to give me 800 for a peace treaty at the minute. Then I guess I could go after the Teeth Snatchers while I consolidate more power. I don't know. What should I do? Do you reckon I should get peace for now? Let me know in the comments below. But at least it will stop me being attacked for a while. I think I might consolidate my tribes. Then I can probably destroy the dwarves at will. Whenever I want. So, I'm struggling at the minute. So my inclination is to get a peace treaty. No peace. Oh my god. You guys are not tactical. You're not tactical. But fine. Okay. Well, let's get this rebellion taken care of. So we actually have a new person, Tricky Wolf Herder. What should we rename him to? What do you reckon we should rename him to? Oh my god, I can't believe you went, "We made a bad decision, smiley face." Well, we'll just have to live with it now, won't we? We will have to live with it. Name him Sigmar? No. Rambler. Oh, actually, yeah, we could have a Rambler. We haven't actually... Yeah, okay, we'll go for a Rambler. Thank you. I don't know why I didn't think of that myself. And this is where he dies. Like, to... My god! So he's got... Night Goblin Fanatics. Well, we're gonna try and fight it. Alex the Mangler. Well, if he survives, I'll change it to Alex the Mangler. But this is just... These freaking rebellions are just, quite frankly, annoying me now. But at least we actually have a... position to defend from this time. Oh, Okay. So there's Fire of the Spider Rider to start with. Fire of the Spider Riders. Oh, here we go. So I killed a few of them. How are they silver tiered? They haven't even done anything. Oh, good lord. So many spider riders and archers. This isn't... I'm not having a nice time. Oh, jeez. I was hoping to take out a bit of his health there, but I don't think that's worked, so we'll just... Are they all, like, archers? And range troops? Okay. So at the minute I can swarm while still firing. We've encountered hidden foes. I don't think it's looking good for a Rambler Wolf Herder. I'm getting frustrated. I just need like two turns to consolidate. Or like a few turns to consolidate without any rebellions. You can go away, Night Goblin Archers. So here we have Rambler. I'm very sexy. We all miss Rambler the Mangler. Yeah. Please fire. How are you not even killing Night Goblins? Wow. Oh, there we go. Well, we killed one. I mean, it's not over. We can take out their lord. Oh. Oh, you... Yeah, you're screwed there. Oh my god, we're taking so much fire. Save the rock lobber. Okay, we're pushing through. It's like they're firing machine guns. They are actually firing machine guns. No, don't run away. Come back here, you gits. So I'm never going to be able to catch them, and they're never going to run out of ammo. Ammo. What am I meant to do? Honestly. Give me 20 good men. 20 good men. Well, Rounder's doing okay. He's inspiring the troops.
No case.
So my war boss is doing okay. What I should have done, in hindsight, is... Actually, let's just target Azag. No, stop firing at me. Stop it. Okay, it's going to be all on Azag versus Rambler. Azag v Rambler, 1v1 me, with the rest of my crew. There we go. Rambler in the battle. Come back here. Killed him. Rambler got his kill. Kill confirmed. Kill confirmed. Okay. Okay, we might have this now. Come on. Face me. Face me. Face me. Gits. Face me. Face me! Kill him. Well, Rambler survived. But at what cost? Men remaining. Oh my god. I can turn off the arrow trails, yes. I'm not going to. I don't mind them. At least I know where I'm shooting. I guess. Oh. Wish I could get reinforcements. Oh, Rambler the Mangler needs to have... Yes. Rambler. You will lead many forces into battle. I'm gonna try and auto resolve it, which I know is like bad to do, but no. Not taking that. I'll fight it. Just rock lob them. I am going to do that. I'm going to rock lob them. Rock lobbing them is the only way. A rock lobster! A rock lobster! Save scumming, unfollowed. Okay, see you later then. Let's scrap. We is gobos. Okay. Right. So their morale pretty much should just fall straight away, I'm hoping. So that's taken out a few of them. I would manual fire, but honestly, no, you don't want to see me manual fire, I'm terrible. But at least we're lobbing rocks. It's taken out quite a few of them, actually. Any we can kill is good for me. So apparently this battle's in my favour. Probably because we've got Rambler the Mangler. But the thing is, like, I'm stuck in this position where I can't really do bugger all against these. And now we've uncovered hidden foes. So, let's focus on taking out a few at a time. In goes Rambler the Mangler. I have indeed seen it. There we go, charging in. Yes, Rambler the Mangler knows what's up. I have seen the Holy Grail. Well, they're not going down without a fight, are they? What do I give it out of 10? 8.5 at the minute. At least I can actually chase down these buggers now. If you would run. Come back. In we go. Well. So my warriors are fleeing. You can keep chasing them. I think Rambler the Mangler is doing pretty well. I am Rambler, King of Manglers. Only problem is I can't chase these frickin' archers. They're just giving me the runaround. Mangler! Well, okay, well we've won again. I think their army should die now. I've beaten them twice in the field, but we're down to 200 men, so I don't think Mangler can take on another force just yet. We will replenish. There we go, so that's that rebellion done. Rambler the Mangler, up to level 3. She's definitely going to go for intimidating presence. Jeez. Grimgor Ironhide is going to go and take on the dwarves. Ah.
Moving.
So, could we assassinate? Oh, you did it!
Don't think so.
Me.
I was not expecting you to be able to do that.
What?
Ugmug the Crooked. Ugmug Crook. Wow. That's pretty alright. Okay, so Rambler the Mangler. You're doing alright. We need to kill these dwarves. Gonna focus on building up Rambler the Mangler's army now. Especially now we can get 5 units. Okay. Okay, now we're actually in a position where we're not getting Stop rebelling. I've had enough of this shit. There's... Why can't you just be happy with my rule? I have got an AI army. That would be my... war army. If Faction destroyed. The Red Eyes. Okay, there we go. We've taken Karak Azul. Is that the capital? Yes, but we're going to have a rebellion there because, you know, who doesn't like rebellions? And a rebellion here. My god, this is just ridiculous. At least that's going well. Reduce the tax. Karak 8 peaks. I don't think it's going to fall. So in the Eastern Badlands, I'm going to get anything that will... So you need to be a level 2 settlement to get a boss tent. Or actually, have I just not got the money? Yep. That is a big dwarf army here. Cazador Dragon Slayer. They do have a minor one down here.
Big on.
So we're going to send Ugmug Crooked over to kind of shadow that army. Rambler the Mangler, we are replenishing. And then I'll probably send them down here to help support the War army. My fightingness rating is going down. So we're going to get a rebellion. Then we'll be able to crush it with Grimgor. Or actually, if we just went into the city for a turn... Okay, so they're going away. In fact, I don't know where any of the dwarven armies are now. No, I take you for an idiot. So Rambler the Mangler is going to essentially ambush this dwarven army that's going towards the Black Iron Mine. We're going to have a rebellion at Karak Azul. So Karak 8 Peaks is doing okay. But just to make sure... I don't have the money. Going to use the underway to go here. Wow. They're going to have a rebellion anyway, so I might as well extort income. Squeakhorn, I'm going to need income from you. I know I'm losing money. When I get there, I'm gonna stab. So, I regret not taking peace with the dwarves. Just saying. I'm gonna fight this one just so I can pretty much obliterate them when Rambler the Mangler comes in. I'm not gonna abandon a single settlement. Right. So that force is pretty depleted. Oh my god. I wonder, can we do this? Just take out the Dragon Slayer. Take out Cazador. Here we go. All on Cazador. We're doing like a suicide charge to try and take him out here. Because they're going to lose anyway. No! Get him. Seriously? Kill him. That's annoying. Right, but these guys are screwed now because they're trapped. The Black Iron Mine, I will of course... Oh, I can't afford to. Okay. Now I can afford to repair you. I need to tax you, unfortunately. But that means I get to a rebellion. Well, let's just... I'm gonna have to sack some settlements for the time being. Oh! Oh! Am I being raided? Is this Burke? Is this Burke's audience? Oh, wow! Bloody hell! This has gone crazy! Hello! Hello, everyone! Welcome! All the booty stolen. Well, that's good timing, really. I sack a settlement, and then the pirates come into play. My god! This is mental! I've never seen my chat go this... Wow! This is raid and pillage. Jeez, Burke. Thank you very much for the raid if you're there. I know you've been streaming for like 20 hours or something. So, wow. Thanks and welcome everyone. This is wow. I'm not used to this. Thanks. For those of you who are just joining, I'm Alex, otherwise known as the Rambler. I'm a Total War focused channel, and welcome pirates of Burke. It appears, yeah, crumbs. So I'm also doing the Greenskins campaign. I appear to be kind of struggling a little bit. Wow, but welcome. Welcome, everyone. Nice to see you all. We are losing income at the minute, so don't judge me too harshly. This province, though, our main province, is actually secure. But yes, thanks, everyone, for the raid. If you want to stick around, I'll be streaming for a little while longer. In fact, I'll probably stick around a bit longer now, seeing as everyone's here. Wow. That's cool. Okay. So we need to repair. I've had trouble dealing with rebellions. So Rambler the Mangler is my main guy. Who needs money? I do. I really need money, so I'm going to go and raid this settlement next with Grimgor. And can I still... I can't use the underway. Actually, I could raid. Income generated from raiding would be 150. That's not a whole lot. I need to keep on going. Because I don't think the dwarves have any armies around me there. They are going to die. I think we can actually use something.
They won't be the thing.
It's the hero. That's his double assassination. That is... it's pretty good. So, I think we're actually going to use you a bit more as a spy. Because you're doing pretty well, sir. Okay. So we're going to continue waging war.
You dare approach me. If I don't like what you say, Mork will be eating your guts tonight.
Yes, Sev, I have done some videos with Lionheart. Indeed I have. They're offering 2,700. You know what? You guys made me decline peace once. I'm just going to keep on declining it. Once we've actually got control of the dwarves here, then I think we'll have a better chance against these tribes. So, screw it. Yeah, I do a podcast with Lionheart. Called the Warcast. Several goblins have been spotted sneaking around the Badlands. It stands to reason that they're up to no good, and there may be some fighting to be had at the end of it. Embed a big boss into the Lord's army.
Yes, boss.
I think he's a big boss. There we go. So that's keeping my tribes going for a little while longer. The cringing goblin revealed that he was on the trail of another orc war boss said to have found a powerful axe somewhere in the mountains and headed north in search of some humies to try it out on. Eager for the chance of loot, the goblin was hurrying to join his mob, but adds that no one has heard from the warboss since, though there are plenty of rumours of him amongst the various greenskin tribes. Grimmore delays his plan to squish the goblin spy and sends him out to find... Oh. No anything of value and torture the information out of them. So, carry out successful assassination attempts against one characters belonging to the greenskins. So I'll do that in a little bit. I need this rebellion to die. That doesn't seem like too much of a difficult rebellion to crush. So Rambler the Mangler, I think we might have a chance here. Apparently I don't. So I'm going to save it and fight it. Is this story or simple? It's a story-based campaign, kind of. But you can still do whatever you want. You don't have to do these quests. But I like to. So, I'm just going to thank Burke for the raid on El Twitter. I've actually met Burke once. Back in November, we were at that Total War thing together. There we go. So... I reckon we have got a chance of winning this, so I'm going to deploy my orc boys, the rock lobber. My orc biggins can go here. So I'm going to try and pepper them first with my rock lobber. They've got lots more archers than I do. Skirt Dribble Chin, my god. Hello, Jazz Khan. This is the most polished title I've seen CA release, I think. Probably by quite a margin, especially on release. So, it's definitely worth... You don't have to worry about there being too many bugs. I'm playing on a high-end system, so I think that kind of reduces the amount of bugs that I would get. Actually, no, I can't even confirm that. That's just me speculating. But yeah, it's very polished. Have the orc biggins behind so they don't take the charge. I will listen to your sage advice, sir. Pull back. So we'll lose a unit of archers. I'm going to move my archers back, actually. And here I'm going to be taking fire, because I can't do anything else. Okay. Just where they have so many, like, frickin' skirmishers. This makes my kind of rush-type army a bit... You know what I'm saying? But we do have Rambler the Mangler on his hog. We are engaging a lot of their troops. Hopefully we can just like rout a load of them. That'll make my job a bit easier. Looks like we're crushing quite a few of them. Oh. Am I going to go back to hot seat? Probably not. So orc boys really aren't a problem for us. Rambler the Mangler, where are you? I think we've got this battle under control now. Any of them who turn around and fight are going to have trouble. Such as here, those Goblin Wolf Riders. My war boss is going in. Rambler the Mangler. You don't get to call a war. They just kind of happen automatically. But it looks like now we've got actually got a fairly decent force. Just having these big ones is making a big difference to the battle. So the sooner we can get this rebellion crushed, the sooner our conquest of said dwarves can continue. So let's focus on mopping up. It's just these archers, man. Okay, I'm going to fall back so we can keep pelting them. I'd rather not take any unnecessary casualties. Dribble chin, your time is coming. Oh, you git. So at least these orc biggins are doing a fairly nice job against the orc boys. They should win. The stunties are gonna get it. Kill the Dribble Chin. That is a fantastic name, by the way. Frickin' Dribble Chin. Okay, you all need to chase him down. Just try and take down as many men as possible. I haven't really played much of the tabletop, I'm afraid, so I can't really give an opinion on the tabletop compared to the board game. Did I tell you to chase him? Yes, I did. I think he might get away. Oh, he got hit! He got hit by the rock lobber! He got hit by the rock lobber. Keep on. Please take him out. Bugger. But a decisive victory, which is, you know, standard with me. This is on hard difficulty. Playing on hard. We are going to eat them. I want to replenish. Oh. Bonus spell. Oh, damn. They're going to... Frick. They're going to get more units. So we're extorting income from there. I think I'm going to just have to deal with the rebellion. At least this province is safe. I just want to make sure I can loot another settlement first. And the garrisons are pretty lame. And then I'll send Grimgore back. And then we'll deal with... the rebellion again. So I might consolidate. I might make peace with the dwarves. Because I just need to do something. Because this can't continue. This constant... So, for that. Oh, yes, we're going to get you on a giant spider. That's the rebellion destroyed. What can I do?
Despair involves fighting.
Right, so I'm going to send you back. Oh, they're not rebelling anymore. Okay, but I can't keep taking that hit on income. My god, man. This is... I could go down to Spite Peak in a turn or two and start conquering some of the dwarven territories. But they are not happy if I... exempt them from income, they're just... it's bad. So, can I do anything? If I upgrade you to a level 2, or a level 3... no point me building heaps of shiny stuff, because... ugh. A boss shack is 3,000. Oh, an orc guardhouse. Don't really need that. I'm going to just make sure that I don't have a problem in my home province. Mount Squighorn. Not going to build that just yet. Can't afford to get that because then I'll run out of money. Okay.
Your conquests strike fear into the hearts of your enemies, mighty lord.
Thank you.
The wisest amongst them will know that fate is on your side. I have foreseen it.
Oh, good, we got a war. Thank you. So we'll set that to go there. Actually. So we're not going to get a rebellion there just yet. I could go and take that settlement. I like how it changes the settlements. That is very nice. So... we're definitely going to get a rebellion there. We'll do that. The War Army can go over there. So we just need to take the Crooked Fang Fort, and then we secure that province. I haven't looked at diplomacy in a while, so we'll take a little look at that. So, a little look. Red Fang still control that. We're slowly eating into the dwarves there. So we're actually strength rank 3. Scrabby Eye again, screwed, so are the Teeth Snatchers. But they would join my confederation. Scabby Eye.
This is my place.
So they're at war with Border Princes, the Top Knots, and the Dwarves. I don't want to take any territory where I'm going to have to worry about that at the minute. The mission to assassinate. Don't forget it. Okay. Yeah, I'll try and remember to do that. Grimgore's gone up another rank. He could be a dodgy geezer. Okay, get back. Oh, yes. Get back here. So, on the turn. Getting into 30 turns. I think I need to start getting control here. Oh, blimey. Beta stickers. Could get Beast of Burden. I'm just going to take the rebellion and just keep on pushing now. To Spite Peak. Got the War Army going down here. Okay. So, Rambler the Mangler is going to be the peacekeeping force in my own territory. So, oh. That's fine now, though. So, get rid of that. You can go and try and take Karaz Agal. We're going to go and take Spike Peak. Banner of Eternal Flame. Okay. I'm going to sack it and then probably take it next turn. Actually, no, I'm going to loot. I could loot and occupy. Conquest penalty is minus 30, though. Provincial instability. I'm just going to sack it. We'll sack it for now. And then, I don't think we can take it in the same turn. We can't. The dwarves have got an army moving in. But I don't really think that they're too much of a threat to me. This is for YouTube. This will go on to YouTube. Yes. And if you do want more Rambler, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel using those Moobot links. It's good stuff, I assure you. I'm just going to try and increase obedience across the board here. And we have a clear... Okay, so let's think about this. I can't get the Troll Cave just yet. I already have a Goblin Tinkerer Bench. So I'm going to take a little look at my buildings, make sure I'm getting what I need to. Right, so that's fine in there. Goblin watchtower and an orc guardhouse. Do I have one of those built anywhere else? Oh, it provides a garrison, so it doesn't enable me to recruit those. Oh. Oh, but in the Badlands, I could actually recruit trolls if I wanted to. So, Rambler the Mangler. No, you can't. Why is that? Oh, it doesn't enable... I'm being a plonker. Okay, it's Troll Cave. When I get... So I need to get a level 3 settlement. So they're upgrading to a level 3. Okay, so I'm right. I get it. I'll getcha. So if I get these up to a level 3. So we'll need to probably come back here at some point. So off he goes. Hello! Welcome back. Ready. Right. You're going to defeat the rebellion that's going to crop up, and then you're probably going to go over there and defeat the rebellion that's going to crop up there. Camp Ruckus. Oh, well, greetings from Canada, Tunglindel.
You dare come before me.
Oh, an underway interception. There we go. Should you want me to fight this? Do you want to see this battle? Like the underground battle? Happy to show it to you if you want. Fight. Okay. We shall fight the Battle of Spite Peak. Right. So, oh wow, it goes into a big old dip. So, let's see what they have. They've got some Quarrelers, Cazador, Quarrelers. They do have a Grudge Thrower, Miners. Is that another Grudge Thrower? They've got another Grudge Thrower. My Doom Diver, though, is triple silver chevron now. Wow. I think my men are going to get a bit tired, so I'm going to get them to walk. Oh. What is Total War about? Give it a Google. Real-time strategy on an epic scale and a turn-based campaign map. I think just walking. We're going to take some casualties with the Grudge Throwers that they have under their command. But I think that's okay. I mean, got 1,800 against theirs. Oh, there we go. Our Doom Diver is going in. I think we're going to hit the Quarrelers, though. So these guys... Oh, that was a nice hit by the Doom Divers. Look at that! Whee! So we've got the Immortals going in. I think we're going to send Grimgor in as well against Cazador. I think it's all on Cazador. Meanwhile, my Doom Diver's still hitting the Quarrelers. My Arrow Boys, I think, are hitting those guys. They've got nothing to protect their Grudge Throwers anymore. So my Lord is attacking. However, I think we've got, like, the Flame buff as well or something. But, yeah, he's getting wrecked. Cazador. You are perishing. This battle doesn't really require too many tactics. Why am I sending all units at one guy? He's the hero, I just wanted to have a bit of fun. But this battle isn't exactly the most difficult in the world to win, so... Hazy. I think it's probably the underground lighting. That's some stuff I'm still not a fan of the lighting. So Cazador is tired. Fly the Doom Diver. Okay, I'll try. I have one, but we'll give it a go. Oh, what? Oh, he's preparing. Whee! No, go down, go down, go down. No, no, go up, go up, go up. Go up, go up, go up, go up, go up, go up. Oh! Okay, let's try that again. We'll try one more. I think we're still in range. No, go up, go up, go up, go up. No, go left, go right. Think. No, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. Oh, no. Missed. But anyway, we won. We won. Hello, Lazy Spartan. Thank you all, by the way, for following. You may have noticed I am a Total War streamer, and I will be streaming more in the future. I'm going to try and make streaming a regular thing. Not always at this time zone, but I usually work during this time zone. I think we're going to replenish. Right. So I think you can go and do the assassinate.
Let's get stabby.
Gork's fist.
Grimoire can. What time is it? I'm currently in Canada, and at the time of playing, it's 20 to 1. So I think we'll go and take Spike Peak. Poof. And immediately I'm going to go for the... Oh, I need to wait until I can upgrade it. Yeah, I'd rather wait till I can upgrade settlements. The Desolation of Nagash. I don't really need too much in there. Is this Rambler the Mangler? Rambler the Mangler. You can go out of that stance. I will engage this rebellion. Crush a Mudcracker. Mudcracker. Oh my god. I am in Vancouver. Okay, so we could just replenish the units by 11. I'm going to do that, just so I can keep on. And now we're actually doing okay. So in... Where's that? Drink of Crackers. I'm going to get one of them. Actually, can I tax the province now? I can tax it. So we're making money. Oh my god. That is a relief. I'm going to get a pile of shiny stuff. Crooked Fang 4. We're just going to be able to get Black Orcs at some point. I do need to get a Wolf Den somewhere. Unless I already have one built. I'm not too fussed about Orc Boar Boys. Rome 2 and Warhammer, they're very similar. I think there might be like occasional differences. Round of the Mangler, leveled up again. Okay, so the Black Crag, Rambler Town, we're going to upgrade.
Mork says what?
Okay, let's take a little look at our... Carry out successful assassination attempt. The Silver Road. That's just ticking over. Not much is going on there. Known factions. So, our empire is starting to expand. We're pushing back the dwarves quite rapidly, actually. Unless you tell me what it is in English, I'm not going to say it. Get Rambler a dragon. Can you actually get a dragon? Rambler the Mangler. You can get a wyvern, which I'm going to definitely let him have. So it appears Rambler the Mangler is becoming quite the general. Quite the general indeed, sir. I'm not sure how much recruitment I'm going to do in Spite Peak, but I'm going to just stop for one turn so we can replenish our troops. It's a pretty basic army there. I mean, yeah, it's going to take too long to get anything. Karak as goal. So we're pushing into some of the dwarves' final settlements now. Oh, my bad. Right, well, growth and obedience will be mine. How about a name a settlement in the Desolation of the Gas from Winnipeg? The dwarves have declared war. Oh my god. Great. Just freaking great! So just as I'm getting stuff secure, just... Yeah, I'm just not gonna say anything you asked me to say. How about that? Not gonna happen, mate. Not gonna happen. Right, so one thing I haven't really done is gained another rank. Blimey. Hard lads. So, I'm gonna take a little look at... Nope. I don't even know if he could use that. But he's got a lot, so we currently got a bully. Swindler. Okay, you're all about the loot, so I'm alright with that. But what about Rambler the Mangler? Let's take a little look at Rambler the Mangler here. Now's the time. Oh, you did it. Okay, so even he's got a high enough fightingness rating. Rambler, you got your own war. Okay. Well, I guess you can go up to the dwarves and go for the Varenka Hills. So that's definitely going to be okay. That should be okay now. That's a shame. So in Spite Peak, we can upgrade you to a level 2 if I left the settlement. Okay. But that's the whole province we control, so that's fine. We're going to move down to the Misty Mountain. Anyway, sorry. I was going to look at Rambler the Mangler. But you could get Gambler's Armor. Rambler the Mangler Gambler. Oh, wait, no, he can't. He can have a charm shield. Okay. Definitely going to just buff up you. Oh, well, what ones hasn't he got? That's something they could improve on. Like, telling me which ones are already assigned to someone. Unless I'm not looking at that correct. Oh, okay. So we can get that. Okay. Sorry. It did have it on the left. So that's just me not being observant. So what do I do with Rambler the Mangler? I think I might send him down there. The Wah is going to go up here. If I lose Squighorn, I'm not too bothered. Karagdron's got a decent-ish garrison. But I could get that. So I can send Rambler the Mangler further down south. Down south. So how far can you get using the underway? A little bit further. Okay. Faction destroyed the Scabby Eye. A stranger comes. Here we go. Well, I'm going to refuse. I don't want Chaos Corruption. So, send this Dark Emissary on his way. Where was the population surplus? Eastern Badlands. Karak, 8 peaks. But it's not enough to build anything.
Beacon!
Okay, so we're still getting that. You can still go for that. But the dwarves are starting to encroach in my territory.
They won't feel a thing.
Please be successful. Okay, so, oh gosh. This will be posted on YouTube afterwards. And I think I'm going to just head off for a little while now. I'm going to go make some lunch and have a couple of bits and bobs, take a little pee break. So, if you're watching this on YouTube, thanks for watching. Thank you for everyone who's tuned in on Twitch. This has been amazing. This is the most viewers I've ever had on a live stream. So, thanks very much. I will be streaming again over the weekend and Monday. So I am going to bid you good day for now, but expect more green skins very soon. And if you haven't followed, make sure to follow, like, all that kind of jazz. Spread this stuff around. And until next time, everyone, I bid you a very, very good day.